welcome back to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. In this video, we finish off making the radius cutter for the lathe and make a pair of spherical washers out of steel to test it. We'll also show you the modifications I've made as I've gone along. So let's go into the workshop and see how we get on. So I've got some 1-inch square bar and I've cut it off to length, which is just a bit shorter than that length. And what I'm going to do is, that's going to be the tool holder bar. This was 1-inch square as well, and I've turned it in the lathe in the four jaw chuck to give me a set length, and I've taken off 1/4 inch off the side, so these will fit on this, and this one's the same, will fit on the other side. I've fitted the base underneath and the centre block, and I'm just going to drill through this. This is a 5mm drill. Drill straight through the bottom block so that all these are in line. This is the chuck I use in my drilling machine, and because the drilling machine has not got an ideal Morse taper, I found that if I put a milling cutter in this, the vibration would cause the chuck to fall out. And obviously when you've got a milling cutter and the chuck falls out, you usually damage your milling cutter. So what I've done is drill a hole straight through the Morse taper. Normally on these chucks, I think they're made in China, the taper part is soft, so you can drill straight through the centre. And to hold it in the drilling machine, stop it falling out, I've got a long piece of silver steel, put a thread on the end, a thread on the other end with a nut. So that goes through the centre of the chuck, and then on this end I screw this part, fits in the slot where you put your drift through. And the only thing you have to do is make sure it's central at the top, so that will not come out once it's in the machine. Now that's the part fitted. As you can see, the piece of steel that forms a nut is there, and you just see the bar coming through the middle. Just watch that this part doesn't foul the inside of the quill, so they can turn round without obstructing. Now if you want to take the chuck out, you just put a socket up the jaws of the chuck, undo the bar, take the nut out the top there, and the chuck can be drifted out as normal. But that will stop the chuck falling out if you've got a bad Morse taper in the top, or you're doing something where the vibration's that bad, it just vibrates the chuck out. I'm just using a small square to set my parting off tool square. This is a tool holder, and it needs to be about just under 45mm from the tip to the end. That's okay. Holding the tool holder I made, there's a tungsten carbide piece on the end here. I've just clamped it into the tool post. This is an end mill, and I just want to put a flat near the bottom of the tool post to hold a grub screw. Piece of emery cloth in a stick, just turn it round, hold it in the chuck, on the emery cloth so it doesn't untwist. And it polishes the bore up. So you get a nice fit. The cap head on the end locks the height of the tool. This is roughly set so that the top of that is the right distance. I've just set in this block here with the cap head in parallel to the chuck so that I can mill the slot down there. These are just packing pieces. I'm using the tool post clamping screw to hold this down. The cutter is just below the edge. I just want to cut maybe 10 thou deep, a groove along that edge. I've had to set my compound slide that way because I haven't got enough travel on the cross slide so that I could set the job further back to give me the travel. There's this cross slide, when I was halfway across, it was coming off the end of the screw. And you can see there, that's just giving me enough travel. Let's see what happens. Just fitted the dial indicator, zeroed it so I can see how much the cut I'm putting on. Lock that up. Idea of this slight recess here, so when these screws are tightened up they will leave a mark, and that mark doesn't stop the tool post sliding in and out. This is the bearing plate with the bearing and the pivot pin going through, and if you remember when we machined this in the four-jaw chuck, we drilled a center drill hole to steady the metal. Now I'm using the centre drill hole on each side to drill 5mm to tap 6mm. I've put a 6mm tap in the drill. Just done some tidying up. I've rounded off these, put a chamfer on the edge, rounded the edge of the block off here. All I need to do now is file off, chamfer the edges and file these bits off. So let's go over the parts that we made. This is the top plate. And that's the dovetail. And the only thing I've changed on the dovetail is I put a recess on the end so that when the pivot pin goes through I can put a nut in there to hold, lock the pivot pin. And you need to make that recess big enough to put a socket in so you can just tighten the nut up. And also what I've done on the top bearing plate is I've just rounded off the edges to make it look a bit better. Gives me a bit more clearance on the lathe. and I've also put two holes there in my crude spanner, so I can just hold that when it's inside and I'll tighten the nut up. Oh, I also relieved this plate to give me a diameter that's flat there, so this is clearance. I haven't touched this face on this plate because I want to use this to put other fixtures and things on. So that goes through there. Little spanner in there to turn this. And then once it's right, put your nut on there. Lock that. Not tight, but there's no play in that, where before it was going up and down, so I've got a nice smooth movement on that now. And if there becomes any more play, you just tighten the nut up, and I'm hoping the lock nut will stop this unscrewing, because it should only pivot on the bearing. I've just bolted these down to the base. I've put a small centre drill mark there, and that's so if I want to take the tool post out, I can put a centre punch in the hole, tap it through without damaging the face. This tool post fits in here. That's the pivot centre there, an 8mm bar. So what I was thinking of doing was putting an 8mm slot in here. So when this is fitted, you can measure from the pivot centre to the tip of the tool and know exactly what radius or ball diameter you're cutting. So you can put that there and you know exactly where the centre of the pivot point is, and you can set the distance there before you put it on the lathe. But I'm not going to do that at the moment, just in case there's some more modifications I need to do. And the handle I'm using is an 8mm rod, 6mm thread on the end, it just screws in there. This one was used for my cutter grinder, and I've got another use for it now. If I need it cranked, I'll get another 6mm rod and just have it bent over. First test of my ball turning fixture on steel. This is quite tough steel, and what I'm doing is I'm making a spherical washer, so I need a dome here, and I'll part that off. Okay, here's the spherical part, roughly on centre line there, comes across to there. It would be about a 3.5 inch ball. I've just set my parting off tool up. All I'm using is a centre, revolving centre, to steady the bar because I was getting a lot of chatter. Explain what I've done. I've rotated the tool, the cutter, So this face, this point of the cutter was over this side, so now it's on the outside. I've turned the whole jig round. This was over this side like that, and the handle was on this end. I've put the handle on the other end, turned it round. Because I'm doing a concave surface, the metal is touching the bottom of the tip, which is giving me a problem. So what I've done is put the lathe in reverse, so I'm cutting on the up and the bottom of the tip is cutting the radius. That's the other side, is the one I parted off earlier, so now I've got a matching socket so that can float in there. These are the two finished spherical washers. That one's got a bigger diameter so it can move, and that fits inside. And that's the finished radius cutter. The modifications I'll probably make is make this bar reduce the diameter, because I did notice it was catching on the spherical concave, so obviously it needs the tip sticking out further, so I can reduce this bar a bit lower down. The other thing I did was put a small pin in the top plate to hold this in position, stop it turning. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and see you next time on Enots Engineering.